for some reason, something in me just decided that like I was super, super interested in the speed that land speed racing has. That's one of the reasons that we're going back, and I just, it's such a refreshing event. I can't wait to go back. Hey there, Peak Squad, Alex Taylor here. So let's talk about Bonneville and land speed racing. So drag racing is my background, and I don't have anybody in my family that's done land speed racing. When I was 16, I don't actually know why I decided I wanted to do this, but when I was probably 16, 15, 16, for some reason, something in me just decided that like I was super, super interested in the speed that land speed racing has. I remember going to my very first drag week in 2013 with the Camaro that's behind me, and Keith Turk was there and his wife Tanya Turk, and they raced their land speed Camaro with David Freiberger. And for some reason, I remember I was talking to him and telling him, like, I didn't know him at the time, and I was telling him all these stories and things about like what I do, and told him I really wanted to go land speed racing. And he's like, well, you need to talk to my wife. And that's Tanya. And that's some of the first memories I have of like actually vocalizing that that's something that I wanted to do. That was in 2013. I think probably watching the movie The World's Fastest Indian with Burt Monroe and his motorcycle is probably partly something that played into it, but I didn't watch that till later. But just the history that the SCTA, the Southern California Timing Association, holds, and it makes me happy. Like, there's just so much history there. It's such an experience that it's really hard to put into words, and that's why I'm struggling right now. But I had never had the chance to actually go land speed racing. Drag racing takes all of our time, all of our budget. Building a car and going out there, it's a totally different world. The rule book is totally different. Not knowing even where to start with registering for events, it seems really out of reach and very hard to do. Land speed racing is not something where you just decide, oh, I wanna go, and you set a goal and you go out and accomplish it that year. You're fighting so much stuff. You're fighting Mother Nature. You're fighting just all kinds of different environmental conditions. A lot of it's out of control. Say you go to a drag strip and it rains out, they have equipment that can reprep the track. You go land speed racing, it rains, you just rained out the meat. The salt, you can't dry the salt. So anyways, it's something that you don't just decide to go do, and you go do and you make it happen right then. So it's just one of those things, I'm like, I'll do it one day. I'll do it one day. And I see all these drag racers that go over to the land speed racing side, so I'm like, there has to be something to it. And it's just something that stayed on my mind. I actually had the chance to go out to Bonneville's Speed Week, I think it was in 2014, with George Poteet. If you know George Poteet, you've heard his name. He drives some of the fastest cars out there. He's incredible. And he invited us out. My mom and dad actually built a couple cars for him years and years and years ago. And so he invited us out, and we went out, and it rained. So it rained it out. I didn't get to see anything. It was super sad, but I did get to see the salt and wet. And it was just like, I want to be out here so bad. I'll be out here one day kind of thing. And then in 2022, Nick had finished up a land speed car. So I flew out to Bonneville with him. I was so excited. I was finally gonna get to see land speed week, and it rained out. And so I was like, man, maybe it's just not for me. Every time I go out here, the event gets rained out. Finally last year in 2023 for Hot Rod Garage, they kept asking me, they're like, what's one thing that you wanna do? And I kept telling them, I was like, I wanna build a car to go land speed racing. I wanna do land speed. I wanna do land speed. And finally they agreed to let me pick a car that we could take to an event around land speed racing. So we built a 32 Roadster that has a Ford flathead engine in it. It wasn't gonna be anything crazy. We're gonna try to do like a little over 100 miles an hour, get my E license, and we're gonna go to El Mirage and celebrate Hot Rod Magazine's 75 years. We finished up the car. We never made it to a meet. We're gonna go in 2024, this year. We're gonna go out for it. But it's so funny how this all played out. I was actually in June, as we're getting the Roadster ready, and I start getting familiarized with the book and the rule book and things like that, I'm starting to feel like we're finally achieving, like getting close to this long time dream of mine to go. I got a call from my dad, and he's like, Keith Turk just called me. There's an opportunity that just came up with a guy that he knows, and he wants to let you drive his Camaro at Speed Week. And this was in June, and Speed Week's in August, the like first and a half, like the 9th of August or something like that. And he's like, but he called me first to make sure I was okay with, like, called my dad first to make sure he was okay with it, to make sure, like, you know, because it's a very, very dangerous activity. So he called my dad. My dad's like, Keith, this is Alex's decision, but thanks for calling me. So we talked about it, and I decided, I was like, you know what? Let's at least see let's go see the car. Let's see if it's even something we want to pursue. But like, I understand the risk of it. I get it. Let's go see if it's interesting. So I've never really driven. I have driven another car that my dad didn't build, but we knew the people and we were pretty cautious with it. And so this one was just like a guy that I'd never met. My dad had never met. We didn't know anything about the car. And so we had this agreement. Me and my dad and Keith flew out at the end of July. That was the soonest we could get out there. We flew out to Arizona at the end of July to meet Roger Beckman and Tim Cox, which were the owners of this car. And it's a pro-charged Camaro. And this is this most radical car, but we had an agreement. We had it when we were driving up. We said, all right, this is like a puppy. You know, you go see a puppy and you want to take it home, even if it's not the dog that you think you want, kind of thing. He's like, we have to agree that if we get there and it doesn't look safe and we don't like the car, we're calling it off. We're not going. And I'm like, okay. He's like, it's going to be really hard. And Keith's like, I don't have a problem telling her no. I'll tell her no. And if you know Keith Dirk, that'll make sense. So we go to the shop and we start looking around the car, and I kind of know stuff to look for, but land speed's totally different. So we start looking around this car and Keith and Dad are like, no, this is solid. Like, we really like it. Keith tells me, he's like, this is better than our Camaro. So anyways, we get to go and we make these plans. They fit the seat to me. We start the car, and at that moment it started feeling real, and I'm like, I'm gonna get to go land speed racing. And we had the goal of going for a Red Hat record, which means that you have to run 200 miles an hour and break a class record, and then you get a red hat, which is incredibly prestigious. And that's a really lofty goal to go out with for one event, because you have to go through the ranks of licensing. Land speed racing is the most safe thing that I've personally experienced, where the crew checks everything. They check your belts to make sure they're tight before you even make a pass. So the red hat, when I say I'm going for a record attempt and a red hat, so you can get a record without getting a red hat. So those are very different. There's red hats, which are 200 mile an hour club. There's blue hats, which are 300 mile an hour club, which is even fewer. But you can get a record without getting the hat. So those two things are very important to me. I almost felt guilty last year because I went out with the intention of getting a record with a red hat. And it's weird saying, I actually had a little guilt because I'm like, I'm coming out here as a brand new rookie saying that I want to get this. This is my goal. And then I realized at the same time that it would be almost selfish if I didn't go for that when I have that opportunity, because it is not easy. As I've touched on a little, going for that, and even if you have the perfect car, even if the car is more than capable of getting that record, you have so many other things that play factors of if you can even get out there. People try for 10 years and don't get the record or don't get the hat. Weather might affect the course, or time might affect it where they don't get their licenses and don't get to run. And so I was like, if I have this opportunity in front of me, I need to take that on, because even though I feel guilty trying to do that, I'd also feel guilty if I left that on the table. So I jumped through hoops of taking planes back and forth for some other obligations I had, because I wanted to make it happen. It didn't happen, but this year going again, it's like I have had Keith and Roger Beckman, which owned the other car, tell me like, we go to Bonneville to set a record. It's too hard of a trip. It's too expensive. You don't just go out to like make a pass on a Friday night like you might at the drag strip. Like, you have to be very committed. There's not events that just happen again and again and again. Speed Week happens once a year. Bonneville holds other events, El Mirage. There's other land speed racing, but there's only one Speed Week a year. And to go out and set that record, he's like, if we're going, we're going to set a record. Like, that's the intention. So I'm adopting that, and it's one of those that if we're gonna do it, we need to make it count. And if we can set a record and get a hat, like, it is such a small club. I don't know the exact number off the top of my head, but it's a very small club. And it's a very few people in the world that hold that accolade. And so that's just one that, to me, it's really important. And you know who has a red hat because you see them walking around, and like, it's really cool. Once you're inducted into that group, the 200 mile an hour club, you can buy merchandise. Like, I look at Keith Turk and Tanya Turk, and they walk around with their 200 mile an hour sweaters, and they have their stickers on everything. And like, you can't buy it unless you have your name in that book. And so it's just something I really look forward to. It's something that is on my goal list of doing as a driver, and I am gonna keep trying until we get there. So really lucky I have the opportunity to do it this early in life at this age, because like I said, other people are trying for years and years and years and years and years. And who knows? I may try for years and years and years and years, but we're gonna try as hard as we can every year we get to do it. So anyway, so we go out, we get out there and it rains out Speed Week 2023. We thought it was going to. We get out there, downpour comes, the salt is trashed, and they ended up holding the event, but it was a short course. It was a 3-mile course. So we go out and I have to go through all my licensing. The line is super long because it's only a partial course that's open. So I got through all of my licensing up to an A license. So that means I can go 200 to 250. I didn't get my AA, which is 250 to 300. I go out, get my license, and I go out to set my record run attempt in the class that we were running, and I broke a rear end gear. So that's what ended my 2023 Speed Week, and I had to fly out. But anyway, so that whole event was the most surreal experience I think I've ever had. I love everything else I do, but going out there and seeing the white landscape of the salt and looking around and realizing you're like this big, like you just realize how small you are in that moment. And I remember watching the very first, I went through my rookie orientation, I go up to the line, and it was about to be the first vehicle down the course of Speed Week 2023. And I get up there and I look and it's a motorcycle. It was the first thing I got to watch. And it, like, I've watched the movie World's Fastest Indian so many times with Burtman Rue. And to see the bike fire up and to see it take off and it just like disappears out into nowhere, it's one of those that like almost makes you cry because it's like, whoa, I just watched that in real life. It's the most crazy feeling. And I wasn't even driving. So then the other time when I actually got in the car, my first pass, I pull up to the line and they warm up the car. The director comes over and makes sure the belts are tight, the helmet's tight, and they give you the good luck. Shut your doors and then they point to you just like that. And you give them the thumbs up, and they go visor down, and they send you on the course. And at that point, the course is yours. And that is the most incredible feeling I think I've ever felt, because it's just like you look at this course and you're like, this is my course. I'm on this course right now. I'm the only person on it, and I'm making this pass. And I remember when the push truck came and it started and it starts pushing me off, and I'm like, it hit me all at once. I'm like, I'm doing this. Like, holy crap, I'm doing this right now. Like, this is happening right this second. And so he pushes me off, and then like you go through the procedure you talked about, and then the push truck goes away and you just take off. And it's just so cool. And then you get out at the top of the run and you look around and no one's around and it's silent. You really have a second to let it sink in. So anyways, I say all of that to paint the picture that this was one of the most craziest feeling that I've ever felt at an event, just because of the silence and the calmness that I felt, even though you're doing incredibly not calm things. You're driving a car over 200 miles an hour and sustaining that speed for a mile. It's so anti-calm and calm all at the same time. It was so rejuvenating to be out there with all the stories and the history and all of that. And unfortunately, Roger Beckman and Tim Cox sold the car, but they sold it to a really nice guy who I might could step in the car at some point, but they sold it to Sean, and I won't be driving that this year. However, I was like, I gotta find a way to go back for this. And my dad didn't get to go with me last year. He's building a car, everybody else went. But we decided, like, we gotta go back. Well, Keith Turk actually made the offer earlier this year, and I'm gonna be driving the Camaro that he and Tanya and David Freiberger race, which is actually a Hot Rod Magazine special car, so it's very, very, very cool for me. So me and my dad are going to be building a small block engine that we're going to use David Freiberger's in a box, like his blow-through setup that he has, and we're gonna be using part of his stuff, but our small block engine. And we get to go back this year, and we're going to go for a record attempt, and we're gonna go for a red hat. That's like, I wanna walk around with a red hat so bad for the 200 mile an hour club. So we're gonna go back, and it's just one of those things that getting to go do that and getting to experience that and listen to the stories that people have out there is something that, that's one side of it that I wanna go just for that enjoyment. It's totally different than drag racing. But it's also, it's so much like Drag Week and stuff that we do, where it's like you set your own personal record or your own personal goal and you go out and chase it. You have to build something that's capable of doing that, and then you get to go prove it. And so that's one of the reasons that we're going back, and I just, it's such a refreshing event. I can't wait to go back. 2024, hopefully, is a good year with weather and everything like that, but we're at Mother Nature's, you know, grace on this event. We're gonna see how it goes, but we're gonna be prepared for Speed Week 2024, which is in August, and we're gonna go see how it goes. But overall, it's just super neat, something that I've wanted to do forever. It's funny, because I finally figured out, I always thought that I liked the speed of drag racing. Now I've got to try a lot of different forms of racing. I always thought it was the speed. And I can say, like, at the core, for my own just like driving enjoyment, I'm still a drag racer at heart, and I realized I like the acceleration. So 200 on the salt is a totally different 200 on the drag strip. The acceleration combined with the mile an hour and the quick time is something where you have so much adrenaline on the drag strip. On land speed racing, it's one of those where I say it's calm. It's because you're doing 200 and you're just holding that. You have no reference, you have no point of reference. So yeah, totally different situation, but I love it. And I am so excited I have the opportunity to go back and go for a record this year.